Hello. Up for auction today is what I call a Kombo Kaboom. What I did is I took the RVNB20, which is a 2008 model, and combined it with two of the older, well-built models from 1998. I used the case from the 1998 version of the B90, and I used the speakers from the limited edition B90 LTD. Those are the only items I took from that unit because it was pretty much in bad shape. But I wanted to try an experiment to see if this would work, and JVC did a really cool thing by allowing boomboxes, their kabooms that were purchased or made between 1998 and 2008, they actually can be combined with no hacking or soldering or anything of the sort to actually make a full boombox kaboom that is fully functional and sounds incredibly awesome. Just so you know, I can tell you the parts that were combined to make this full unit. The case was the B90, the speakers, the front speakers were the B90 limited edition blue. The subs are from the NB20, the CD player, and the front panel from the NB20. The power supply is from the NB20, the subs are from the NB20. The tuner is from the B90, and that's basically it. And the cool thing is everything functions perfectly. As you can see, I will turn it on, and you can see that it is saying it's reading the MP3 disc that I put in there. Yeah, take a second, like it does with all the kabooms that read their MP3 disc. Give it a sec. There we go. Now it is reading it. Turn the volume down a little bit. This is the CD. We'll just go through a couple songs here. Let's see. Sorry, these are all Mariah Carey's new album. Let's try this one. The Hall of Notes. How's that sound? Adult Education. If you guys have ever heard that, it was by Hall and Oates.
Adult.
Well, the bass that's coming out of this is fantastic. I mean, thumping bass that we all love from the Kabooms. I also added, in the old units, they also had padding inside behind the subs, and I added that back in so that it's even more solid, if that can even be possible. Go to clear. While combining these units, the front panel on the NB20 was cracked, so I used the panel from the B90, and I had to get rid of the standby light. Was not on the original B90. Makes no difference whatsoever, does nothing to the unit. You just don't get the standby light anymore. That was the only change on the front. Also, we have the auxiliary is now located in the front of the unit, and it functions just like the one in the back did, only on the B90, because this is the MB20, I had to take the auxiliary is located in the front of the MB20, so the one in the back had to disappear. I can't use it because it doesn't exist on the NB20. Well, this is more convenient if you ask me anyway. So the only, and there's no guitar input because the B90, which was the original unit, never had a guitar input on it. So that was also eliminated. So if you like using your guitar on this, you cannot use it. As you can see, now even though this is the B90 tuner, It comes in as if it was the NB20 tuner. That is what's so cool about this. It works and functions as if it was. It sounds fantastic. There's no hiss, there's no hum, there's none of that. It's an extremely quiet unit. What I'll do is I'll show you the back of the unit so you can see. Also, before I do that, you can see that I have the iPod dock connection hooked up to the... You get a brand new remote. The remote is brand spanking new. The iPod dock is new, and including the cable is also new. Those combined are like $60 just to get those three pieces. But they're all brand new. I don't have a iPod. I sold both the units that I had. Of course, I should have taken video prior to that. But the iPod Touch 3G and 4G work perfectly with this unit. There's no compatibility issues whatsoever. And of course, I had to find somebody that had an iPod or an iPhone 4 because I wanted to make sure it was compatible with that too. So somebody at work had one, and I brought this in and I hooked it up, and it said it was not compatible with it, but everything worked like it would normally work. On the remote, you could change to the next song just like you would do with a compatible unit. So the iPhone iPhone 4 will work with this unit. It'll just say that it doesn't, but it does. And I think that's pretty impressive anyway, considering this unit was made 2.5, almost 3 years ago. Anyway, we're gonna take a look around back so you can see. Pardon my, you probably can't see it that well. But as you can see, this is a B90 case. So you just have the headphone, and this is empty. This is the only mod to the unit that, unless you're really looking for it, there's just a hole here, but I did put some tape over it so no dust would get in the unit. As you can see, I use the silver caps. You get the battery back. It's a very clean unit. Because I know that even though combining three units, some people might be a little skeptical, I will warranty this item because all the parts inside are interchangeable. So this, it took, you know, I took a risk in doing so because you never know what'll happen. But the cassette deck portion that was here, I just put this in its place, and the wiring was exactly the same. There was no modifications whatsoever to this unit. I just wanted to let you know. Other than taking the guitar jack and volume off and the lack of the standby, which, in all honesty, that there's normally a spot for the LED on here anyway, on the B90. It's really cool that JVC, even though they're 10 years apart, was able to use the same parts, which, you know, probably be considered cheap. But I don't even know what you think, but solid, this is a very solid unit. These Kabooms are known for not only being solid and be able to take a beating, but the bass is just phenomenal off of this. Also, you will get your choice of the limited edition blue JVC strap or handle, or the black. You let me know when you purchase it which one you would prefer. This is the rare one because there's not many of these blue limited edition Kaboom boxes out on the market. I've only seen a couple. Also, this is really beat up, but this will also be included. This is the original NB20 remote holder, but it's gone through the mill a little bit. This is how I received it, but it will hold the remote and protect it, and that just, you know, it serves its purpose well. But as you can see, I tested everything on this unit. You know the compatibility with the 3G and the 4G of the iPod Touches, and the iPhone 4 does work with this unit. It'll say that it doesn't, but it does. I tested it, and it does work. And I have to thank the guy at work that allowed me to test with his very expensive iPhone 4. Anyway, as you can see, these speakers are cool because they're the only part that I took off of the blue limited edition, and I think it really adds to the overall look of the Kaboom as a result. Anyway, I'm just going to crank it a little bit more on the CD so that you can see how awesome it sounds. I think I got, let's see, we'll go up a little bit because I know you guys just want to hear the sound of this bad boy. which I completely understand. Let's see. All in oats. We got man eater. Method of modern love. That sounds about right. I just hastily threw this disc together. It's brand new, so. Man, the bass that comes out of this is phenomenal. It's shaking the floor. And that's only at 28 volume. Beautiful sound. Anyway, I don't want to fill you with Mala notes. Some of you people might not like it. Anyway, this is going to be up for auction. I give a 30-day warranty as long as you don't, you know, crank the living crap out of it and blow the speakers. I won't warranty against irresponsibility. But I will warranty against any of the parts on this unit. I know, I built this myself. I'm very good with electronics. And you will not be disappointed with this unit. It will give you many years of enjoyment. The CD player makes no noise whatsoever, like it's having problems reading the disc or anything. It's very smooth, and I can barely hear it when it's reading it, when it's searching for the songs and whatnot. Anyway, I got to end this because it's getting pretty long anyway. But good luck on the auction.